Okay, since the last time I was messing with this, I have made up a few wires just with crimp connectors and put them onto the optical sensors. I've made up a little button panel, hooked all out to some inputs on the Arduino, removed that knob because I didn't need it anymore, but I did use it to calibrate the servo motor so that I knew what the positions were. And the hardest part of all this was coding up a really simple Arduino sketch to do this. So I've got the two buttons, red button for the Y and black button for the main line. So I hit the red button, hit the black button, there it is. Now then, the more impressive part, or at least to me, it's the more impressive part. Let's pause for a second here. Okay, and here's how it works. Right now, I've got it set for the diverging route into the Y. That mainline operator comes along, not paying attention to the signals. Oh no. There we go. Switches. Same thing coming from the siding, which is on the wig of the Y. So that is going to make solo operating a whole bunch easier and less derailment prone, I hope. Now I just have to replicate that a dozen times around the layout, which, now that I've got this figured out, should be really straightforward, I hope. Okay, in case you're curious, here's the code that makes it happen. Good chunk of this is just copy and pasted out of the one of the library examples, but here we go. So include the servo because we're using a servo. Created a servo object. Set up some variables. 97 is the servo position for the main line. That was just I determined that just experimentally. I used the other sketch that I'd used earlier, the knob demo sketch, and just put a print in there and rotated it until it was in the right spot. And then 4 and 5 are just the pins that the two inputs are on. I called them buttons, but well, they are buttons, but they're also the optical sensors. And then down here, just do some setup stuff. Oh, I'm not going to need that anymore. I'm finished debugging. Then just set the two input pins to inputs and set them pull up so that when they go low is what makes them trigger. Some leftover debugging stuff. Just read the two buttons and assign them to variables. If the main is pushed, then set the servo to position 97. If that's not pushed, check and see if the Y button's pushed or the Y sensor. And if it is, then set it to 73. All this is just debugging stuff that I don't need anymore. And then you set the rotation to the servo and wait a little bit and jump up the loop and do it all again. That's it. As an Arduino sketch goes, it's pretty simple.